For the first 24 years of the 19th century, trade unions were illegal, the result of the combination laws passed in 1799 and 1800. Introduced by William Pitt, these acts prevented workers from forming unions or combinations for obtaining an advance of wages or for lessening their hours of working. For radicals like Francis Place and their supporters in Parliament, Joseph Hume and Sir Francis Burdett especially, these laws were not only crude reactionary hangovers from the war with France, when such associations were viewed with particular suspicion, they were also ineffective. Trade unions still existed in all but name, most calling themselves friendly societies. Making them illegal only caused resentment. What is more, some labourers found themselves compelled to join a society, as the case of Samuel Starling and James Mills illustrates. Here at the National Archives, we find documents detailing how Starling and Mills were charged with breaking the combination laws by belonging to a society of journeymen shoemakers. Starling confessed that he belonged to the society while being employed as a lady shoemaker by Mr. Max, but explained, "I was discharged last week because my master said the other men would not work with me if I didn't belong to a society." Starling continued to explain how the society worked. They meet once a fortnight at 8 in the evening on Mondays. There is a subscription at each meeting of 3 pence from each member, besides spending the value of a pot of beer for the benefit of the health of members who did not attend. Starling had his doubts about how the subscription money was spent though. "I don't at all know how the funds are applied. Nothing that I ever heard was given to a member in case of sickness, except perhaps to a favoured member." Defaulting on these subscriptions could have serious consequences though, as Starling continued. "If the subscriptions and fees are not cleared at particular times, the defaulter is fined another 1 pence. I am now in arrears of 5 shillings and 3 pence, for which the society has struck me off, and I am thrown out of work." Mills' testimony echoed Starling's, stating that he too had been turned out because I would not pay a fine of a shilling, which I did not think had been justly imposed. Starling and Mills' predicament was not unique. Being caught between being a member of a potentially illegal society and forced to pay its fees, or risk unemployment. In the unfortunate case of Starling and Mills, they not only racked up debts to their society and lost their jobs, but they were also found guilty of being a member of an illegal association under the Combination Acts, most likely resulting in 2 months' imprisonment or 3 months' hard labour.